I'm Lois Stack with the University of Maine Cooperative Extension in Orono, Maine. I work with Maine's landscape, nursery, greenhouse industry, and also with home gardeners. And increasingly over the last few years, one topic has dominated my conversations, and that's invasive plants. Invasive plants aren't just weeds. Weeds are plants that get out of place and come into your yard in the wrong place. But an invasive plant is a plant that has a number of characteristics. Invasive plants are not a new issue in Maine, but they've become more important in the last few years for two reasons. First of all, we have a lot more commerce and a lot more plants coming into Maine. And second, we have global climate change, which is allowing plants that didn't used to survive in Maine survive our winters. Invasive plants cause a lot of problems. In our natural areas, they outcompete plants and animals, change the diet of our animals, and cause serious problems with our native communities. Number two, in recreation areas, they can clog waterways and cause economic problems to the tourist industry of Maine. And number three, in our own backyards, they cause a lot of anxiety and grief, and they can cause our property values to go down. So what can you do about invasive plants? There are five good plans of action. First, don't buy invasive plants. If you go to a place that's selling a plant like this one, this is Norway maple, which is a common street tree and is becoming invasive in Maine, ask the question, find out if it's invasive, and then find an alternative plant. Number two, replace the invasives that are in your yard. This plant I'm standing in front of is one of the invasive honeysuckles. It's Morrow's honeysuckle. And rather than leaving a plant like this, which is which outcompetes a lot of other shrubs and understory in your yard, you could replace it with another wildlife shrub. Number three, volunteer for a community cleanup project. Those invasive plants that are out there are not going to go away without our help. Number four, educate your neighbors. Many invasive plant problems move from one yard to the other. For example, this plant is a vine. This is Asiatic bittersweet. It climbs and actually throttles large trees, and the seeds are moved around by birds. So if your neighbors have it, you may have it in a few years, thanks to those birds. And number five, talk to park managers, public town managers, town officials, and find out if there's some project that you might start or if you can influence the plantings in your town. For more information, go to the website at the end of our video.